Him to a match that is my specialty. But every time I see him wrestle, I see him on the DVDs or in real life, I don't know. I think I might have went over my head a little. I gotta go talk to someone who knows a lot more than me about this sort of stuff.
Heard you were looking for some help.
Yeah, I need some consulting.
It's like you got quite the dilemma here.
I do. I think I may have bitten off a little bit more than I could chew. Because when I got this title, the title I've been wanting for over 4 months, constantly wrestling and getting the hell beat out of me and everything, by that man right there, Killer. I don't know, I think I might have made a mistake. What's your advice?
You know, let the fear lead the way. Fear is the key. This here means more to you than anything in the world. Because I know what you did to get it. It's okay to be scared. Fear is gonna take you to the next level. You are gonna put yourself through things that you did not think you could go to. You are gonna go to a different level. You're gonna be scared. But that fear is gonna give you more adrenaline. It's gonna give you what you need to bring this home. Do you understand? You get it? You're starting to like it, aren't you? You're liking it a little bit, aren't you? Yeah. Oh yeah, the fear's gonna lead the way, my friend. And you're gonna bring this home. And you know why I know you're gonna bring this home?
Why?
Cause I got your back! We're in this together! All the way! That's right, folks. It's headlines, baby. Z Money has got Burbs back. He's rocking the hat. He's got the dollars. He's got the money in his corner. And I'm gonna show him what he needs to be successful in the barbed wire. Because I'm the king of the barbed wire. So, Killer, if you think it's gonna be a cakewalk to win this belt, you got another thing coming. He's gonna be ready. So you better be. That's right. Halloween Havoc, we're gonna be ready, Killer. Are you?
You done fucked up by accepting my challenge. Because this is staying with me.
And I'm going to make sure of it. Because the man with the money has always got a backup plan.
Yeah!
It's starting to go away, isn't it? starting to hurt a little less. You know why it hurts a little less? Because you're calm. You're calm. You're comfortable. You're relaxed. Your fear is not getting to you. Feel better about it? All right. Get up. Well, how do you feel?
I'm starting to like it.
How about now? Ah! You like it now? Huh? You get used to it? Are you?
Yeah.
Yeah? Really? Huh? You're liking it, aren't you? You're liking it, huh? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it feels good. Oh, yeah. Now we're getting somewhere. Yeah, we're getting somewhere. See? Killer, you're done, my friend. You're done. You're done. You're finished. You're through. Your title chances at Halloween Havoc are over. He loves the barbed wire just as much as I do. Oh yeah! I have created a monster. And that monster killer will be responsible for your demise. And it's nobody's fault but yours. Brought this on yourself, my friend. Nothing will stop this man. Nothing. Not a thing. Look, I'm poking him with it. I'm poking him with it. I'm stepping on it. And you think you're gonna be able to stop him? At Halloween Havoc? Uh-uh. No way. See, I'm a gambling man, killer. But I don't gamble unless I'm gonna win. I'd take a gamble on your little buddy. And I hate to say it, but I always come out on top. Just like I'll come out on top and I only have it. Why? Because I manage a man without fear. What do you say, Burbs? Huh? No pain. No pain! No pain! You feel nothing! Huh? No pain! No pain! I think we're about done here. See you at Halloween Havoc, killer. Let's get the hell out of here, champ. Come on. Come on. There. Hold on to that, since it ain't going anywhere. Peace, little buddy.
One more thing, killer. after Halloween Havoc, I feel really sorry for you. Because as the saying goes, barbed wire changes a man, whether it be for better or for worse. You just got the wrong end of the deal.
You know, there's an old adage in the wrestling industry. And that adage is, to be the man, you gotta beat the man. And killer, that is the man. Good day, buddy. You're on the road to victory, my friend. Alright, this is S.A.W. Beyond the Grass. I am your host, Z-Money. And I happen to be sitting here with the Deathmatch Champion, Burbs. First of all, Burbs, I want to say again, congratulations on your victory a few weeks back on winning that third Deathmatch title. I know you've been looking for that belt for a while now, and finally got it. So I guess the first question is, how do you feel about winning that, and about the challenges you're coming up against here? More importantly, the one you got coming up next with Killer.
I joined SAW over 4 months ago, back in June. I believe it was June 15th, and the very first match I ever saw in my life was Trashman and Twitch for this title. I knew from that point this would be the first title I would ever hold. Yeah, it wasn't really the first one I held, because I held the hardcore. Don't even know why, but hey, it's a title. Or was. But the moment I got this title from beating your brother and yourself, with all due respect, you both beat the hell out of me. It was a fun, brutal, insane match. I loved it.
We're gonna have some more, don't you worry.
Oh, hell yeah. I'd be upset if we didn't, man. But with that all aside, you brought up another part of that question. What do I feel about my upcoming challenges? Killer, 2 weeks ago, beat my brother, Sick Boy, in a match for a normal contender. He won it straight down the middle. You know, no cheap shots or none. I respect that. But because of how hard Killer wrestles, I mean, he's been the Inner City Champion 4 or 5 times. I can't, multiple time tag team champion, and as of late, heavyweight champion. I had to up the stakes a little bit. So I challenged him to a barbed wire massacre match. If you guys watched the tapes, it didn't really work out in my favor. I got left on my back after a pretty good choke slam, and Killer walked off thinking he would get, you know, he got the upper hand. Then last week, in the 8-9 man battle royale that we had, can't remember, he pinned me. I know he's going around thinking, oh, that title's mine. He's not taking it. He will have to kill me. And I mean that, kill me, in order to take this title. This title right here means more to me than life itself. It's something I've always wanted. Yes, there's one more title I've always wanted, the heavyweight. But I'll get that later on in time. But I'll be damned if Killer's gonna beat me in my own match.
Now, I know you. You know you're a smart guy. You've probably been. I know you've been doing your homework on Killer.
Oh yeah.
I know you've been doing your homework on killers. So, what are you going to do to counteract the high flying that he brings to the table? Because you know he's going to throw himself at you.
Oh, I know. But Killer thinks he's going to walk in here, do what he can, does best, fly around. I've been up against Killer and his former tag team partner before in a handicap match. I know what they both can do. But what Killer does not know and does not really understand, you can't jump off of a ladder. You can't do a drop kick. Can't do an Arabian face buster or anything like that if you can't walk. See, at the last pay-per-view, guilty as charged. His tag team partner put him out of action almost indefinitely because he dang near broke his knee. Killer thinks he's up for the up to wrestle. He's medically cleared and everything. I'm not holding back at all, and he's not going to be able to do nothing if he cannot walk, let alone stand.
So far, that's your plan of attack, huh?
Yeah.
Well, all right.
I got some other things in plan for Killer, but I'm not going to disclose them here. Now, everybody's just going to have to wait until, you know,
see?
Not even my fiance Jordan knows what they are, and I tell her everything.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure you've heard the things that Mark, Sick Boy, has said the past few weeks. And, you know, you two being, you know, kind of like brothers, I'm sure the S.A.W. fans want to know your opinion on that. So, I guess that's my next question. What is your opinion on the things that Mark said?
My opinions on what my brother said are two things. One, and look at me, look at the screen when I'm talking. What you said about me was just wrong. Just because, yeah, back 2-3 years ago when we were in Nelson Block, I was the heavyweight champion. I'm still the hardcore champion from the Nelson Block. I've held that title, hell, for 9 years, taking it everywhere. And I try to go at a new angle with my character. And you call me a bitch. You degrade me every time I talk to you on the phone. What the hell type of brother does that? Then when I talk to you about your accomplishments in SAW, which to this point was given the tag team title, you freak out at me like I just killed your cat. You know, that doesn't make sense. But it's alright for me. I'm supposed to just say, oh, ha ha ha, fuck you type thing. You know, not paying it no mind. That ain't gonna fly. But I also found out earlier today from my brother that apparently he's done with SAW. Because, you know, the carnival smiled upon him or something. And he's actually now going with Knothead and Mad Max. You know, helping them do their music, which is, hey, go for it. Wrestling's never been your sport. It's never been in your heart. Whenever you stepped into that ring, you showed the fire and the intensity of a wrestler for about 5 minutes. Then you turned into a bitch. Whined and pissed and moaned about everything. When something doesn't go your way, what do? Screaming, whine, and everything else. Blame everybody else for your own stupidity. Your promo that you did was your fault. Nobody else's. What happens? You start freaking out because of the consequences. So, yeah. I love you, brother. You'll always be my brother until the day you die. but this isn't your field. You chose wrong when you showed up, and it was my fault that I called you. But good luck on your events with Knothead and Mad Max, because I know that's a better field for you.
Burbs, my question is, after you're done facing Killer, if you walk out on top, after you're done facing Killer, if left up to you, who would you pick to be your next challenge?
Honestly, my very first day in S.A.W., I called King Chaos and Master Mayhem pussies. Yeah, I got beat up by them for it, but I did that to make a point. I fought in Killer, Shadow, Madman, no wait, scratch that, cut that out, Iron Man, I've wrestled everybody except for one person one-on-one, and that's Madman. So I'm just making it a challenge to you, Madman. Not for any titles, not for, you know, high stakes or anything like that. I just want a match with you sometime before, you know, the season's over and we'll all go back for training full time. I just want to see where I stand with the big boys. You know, because I've been thinking constantly about what type of match would it be? How awesome would it be? Because I know Madman's not afraid to bleed. I know he's not afraid to taste barbed wire. I know he's not afraid to get put through the table or get his head cracked open with a chair. Neither am I. So, some other time later on down the road, I would love to wrestle Madman. Just one-on-one, no interference, blah, blah, blah.
Now, I know from experience, I've wrestled Madman on more than one occasion.
That I know.
He is one of the most fun people there is to wrestle.
That's what I want. I mean, I wanted the match to be brutal.
Yeah, he beats your ass. Don't get me. He beats your ass, let me tell you.
Hey, I have no problem with
that. He'll fucking beat your ass, but the bottom line is no matter who he wrestles, he could wrestle somebody that's had no prior training and he'll make it a damn good match.
Yeah, because ever since I've won this title, I've been, you know, thinking, okay, I'm climbing the ladder. I want to wrestle Madman. I don't care if I win or lose. I just want to wrestle him just to see where I stand with all the big guys. And I don't care how bloody of a match it is, how brutal, how violent, how destructive, if I'm going to the hospital, is he going to the hospital? I just want to see where I stand.
You say, I got something that I got to say here. You know, you say you're climbing the ladder.
Mm-hmm.
You're climbing the ladder of success. But the one thing that you have not done, you haven't beaten me. Just you and me. You haven't beaten me yet. Now, I had to cancel our match for this weekend due to injury.
Because
I got risk of puncturing a lung. But I want to let you know that there will be time. There will be a time down the road.
Oh, yeah.
When you and I cross paths. And when you beat me, I'll give you the respect you want. Because I've been doing this for years. I fell off the truck, but I didn't fall off the truck yesterday. I've been doing this for years. And until you take me to the level that I know that you have inside, you're not going to get my full respect. I respect what you've done, because there's no way in hell you're going to get that belt without earning it. You're not just, you didn't get the belt handed to you like, you know, somebody else we know that happened to get it. handed the tag team title, but, you know, that's another story. Anyway, you didn't get handed that belt. You had to earn it. But I don't feel that you're at your best. I haven't seen your best. You and I have wrestled 3 separate occasions, 3 weeks in a row. And you haven't been your best. And until that time comes, until I'm all healed up, and until I'm ready to go, and I'm back at 100%, you're not going to get my full respect. I'm not going to give you your props. I'm not going to give you your dues until you beat me. One-on-one. Not with anybody else. Not in a triple threat. Not in a fatal four-way. Not in a battle royal. Just you and me. Until that happens, you're not at the top of the ladder. I'm sorry, that's just how it goes. In terms of hardcore wrestling, and in terms of barbed wire and thumbtacks, and falling, taking high flights, falling off roofs. This is my first picking. Until you beat me, you aren't the king of the deathmatch. You haven't climbed the ladder yet. You got a few rungs to go. But our time will definitely come. And we're going to see what you're made of.
I look forward to it.
I know you do. I can see it in your eyes. But I'm just telling you, when that time comes, you better be ready. Because I got something up my sleeve that nobody's seen before. You better be ready. You better start getting that spinning in the back of your mind. And I know it's spinning already. And I know you're going to lose sleep about what I got going in my head and what I got going up my sleeve. You will lose sleep over it. And you're going to be afraid. Very afraid. Because I am going to take you to new heights. Because I know that is what has to happen for you to get to be where you want to be. You want that world heavyweight title. Something's got to come out of you that you haven't seen before. And I am going to be the one to take you to that level. Nobody else. Me. I just want you to know that.